Mind your decisions, I'm Presh Talwalkar. Inside a semicircle, two side-by-side squares are inscribed. If the semicircle's radius is equal to 10, can you solve for the total area of the two squares? If no, demonstrate why not. If yes, calculate the answer. This problem is adapted from Math Stack Exchange. Be sure to consider all possible ways that two side-by-side squares could be inscribed in the semicircle. Pause if you'd like to give this problem a try, and when you're ready, keep watching to learn how to solve this problem. In a right triangle with legs of A and B and a hypotenuse C, we all know that A squared plus B squared is equal to C squared, but what should this rule be called? According to mathematician Munjal Bhargav, who's a Fields Medal winner, the Pythagorean theorem is clearly the wrong name. It should either be an Egyptian theorem, if you look at the standard of just having an idea about it, an Indian theorem, if you're looking for a complete statement of it, or a Chinese theorem if you're looking for the proof of it. I'm preferential towards the proof of it, and I suggest we call it the Gougo theorem, which is what the theorem is known as in China. Getting the history correct is very important. As Munjal Bhargav explains, knowing the correct history of mathematics was useful in my own research because if you learn from the original source how an idea came about, that can give you great insight. Now let's solve the problem. Suppose one square has a side length of x and the other square has a side length of y. The total area of the two squares will be equal to x squared plus y squared. Draw the diagonal of the x square. Its diagonal length will be equal to x times the square root of 2, and the diagonal will bisect the right angle into two 45 degree angles. Now draw the other diagonal. Its length will be equal to y times the square root of 2, and it will form a 45 degree angle right here. Thus, the two diagonals form a 90 degree right angle. Draw a chord connecting these diagonals and call it Z. This is a right triangle, so we can use the Gougo theorem to deduce the length of Z squared. This simplifies to be 2x squared plus 2y squared. We'll now figure out the measure of this circular arc. We'll focus on this diagram and reflect the entire diagram across the diameter. What is the measure of this inscribed angle? It will bisect the right angle of the square, therefore it'll be equal to 45 degrees. We can thus calculate the measure of this circular arc by the inscribed angle theorem. It'll be equal to 2 times 45 degrees, or 90 degrees. How does this help us? We'll go back to our diagram and consider another way to calculate this chord Z. From the center of the circle, draw radii to the endpoints of the chord. Since this circular arc is 90 degrees, this central angle will be equal to 90 degrees as well. It'll be a right angle. We can thus apply the Gougo theorem again to get z squared is equal to r squared plus r squared. We now have two equations which will simplify. The second equation simplifies to be 2r squared, and since both equations are equal to z squared, we set them equal to each other. We then divide by 2 to get x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. Thus, the total area will be equal to r squared. If r is equal to 10, it's equal to 10 squared, which is equal to 100. And that's our answer, regardless of how the two side-by-side squares are inscribed. Incredible! Thanks for making Mind Your Decisions one of the best channels on YouTube. As always, thanks for watching, and thanks for your support.